In this video, we will discuss Guillain-Barré syndrome. But before we start, we have few questions and get the answer after we are done the topic. The first question are, what are different types of Guillain-Barré syndromes? Number two, what's albuminocytologic dissociation? Number three, what are the features of autonomic system involvement in GPS? Number four, what's Miller-Fisher syndrome? Number five, which infectious agents are implicated in causing Guillain-Barré syndrome? And number six, why there is full recovery in demyelinating Guillain-Barré syndrome? So now let's discuss Guillain-Barré syndrome. Guillain-Barré syndrome, GBS, is an acute fulminant demyelinating disorder that causes ascending symmetrical polyneuropathy. Ascending symmetrical polyneuropathy causes areflexic motor paralysis with or without sensory disturbances that follows respiratory illness and involves the peripheral nerves. So what are different types of Guillain-Barré syndromes? There are two different subtypes of Guillain-Barré syndromes: demyelinating variety, which has a full recovery, and an axonal type, which has a poor recovery. Number one, demyelinating type. It has two types. The demyelinating types have full recovery due to remyelination. Why full recovery due to remyelination? Axonal connections remain intact. Axon remains intact, so recovery can take place as remyelination occurs. In demyelinating form, flaccid paralysis and secondary disturbance is due to conduction block. There are two types of demyelinating Guillain-Barré syndromes. Number A, widespread myelin damage. There are macrophages activation and lymphocytic infiltration. And type B demyelinating is Miller-Fisher syndrome, in which there is no weakness, but there is ataxia. Antibodies are anti-GQ1B antibody in 90% of cases. Now, axonal type. Axonal type GBS also has two types. The axonal degeneration causes A, slow recovery, number one, and B, greater degree of disability. So, axonal type causes slow recovery and greater degree of disability. There are two types of axonal types. Number one, AMN, acute motor axonal neuropathy. And number two, AMSEN, AMSEN, acute motor sensory axonal neuropathy. In AMN, acute motor axonal neuropathy, there are anti-GD1A antibodies. This one first attacks nodes of Ranvier. There is macrophage activation and few lymphocytes. Whereas in second type, AMSEN, acute motor sensory axonal neuropathy, that affect both motor and sensory nerves. AMSEN type, axonal damage is usually severe, so more disability in AMSEN type. Etiology and pathology of GBS. It's an autoimmune or infectious demyelinating polyneuropathy in which both cellular and humoral immunity cause tissue damage. Exogenous triggering factors activate T antigens, and then these T antigens attack on the myelin sheets of the peripheral nerves, leading to activation of autoimmune response in cooperation with B lymphocytes. So what's the effect of T cell activation? T cell activation causes in the serum increase in cytokines and interleukins, and in the CSF it causes increase in interleukin 6, TNF alpha and TNF gamma. Antibodies against ganglioside are present in large quantity at the nodes of Ranvier and the nervous tissue. Anti-ganglioside antibodies are common in GBS, up to 20 to 50%, particularly in cases preceded by Campylobacter jejuni. So this is the infection. Campylobacter jejuni is most commonly implicated. Next, autoantibodies also play important role in GBS. Immunoglobulin G antibodies against Schwann cells and neurons are also present. Hodgkin disease, lymphoma, HIV, SLE patients may also suffer Guillain-Barré syndrome. Now, infectious agents implicated in causing GBS. Campylobacter jejuni is the most common organism, as I earlier told. Other agents are Epstein-Barr virus, influenza virus, and Mycoplasma pneumonia. Vaccination may also follow GBS. 70% of GBS cases occur 1 to 3 weeks after an acute infection. So 70% after acute infection. 30% with Campylobacter jejuni and another 30% with cytomegalovirus or Epstein-Barr virus infection. Now, clinical features of Guillain-Barré syndrome. The patient is afebrile, no fever, areflexic, and areflexia occur within the first few days. There is atonia and flaccidity that begins in the lower limb usually. There is loss of position sense, proprioception, dorsal column involvement, pain and numbness, and the patient feels rubbery legs. So rubbery leg feeling with afebrile, areflexic, atonic and flaccid muscles. Lower cranial nerve involvement causing bulbar weakness. So lower cranial nerves and lower limb involve more than the others. So the bulbar weakness, what does it cause? It causes respiratory difficulties. What are the features of autonomic system involvement in Guillain-Barré syndrome? Wide variation in BP, postural hypotension and cardiac dysrhythmia. Facial nerve involvement. What percent of patient has? 50% of the patient have facial nerve involvement. Guillain-Barré syndrome with facial and bulbar paralysis may be associated with antecedent cytomegalovirus infection and anti-GM2 antibodies. So facial nerve involvement and bulbar paralysis after cytomegalovirus infection more common. So what's the prognosis? 85% of patients have full recovery when several months to a year after the illness, and the mortality rate is 5%. The lab investigation and lab findings in Guillain-Barré syndrome. Number one, CSF. In CSF, there is albuminocytologic dissociation. And what's albuminocytologic dissociation? There is increase in protein but normal cell count. No pleocytosis. CSF, when does CSF protein increase? That increases at the end of the first week. So areflexia occurring in the first 2 days and increase in protein occurring at the end of first week. Increase in protein with increase in cell count indicates a viral myelitis or HIV infection. What about tau proteins? Tau protein may increase during the first few days and indicate axonal damage. So it's more dangerous. Appearance of tau protein indicates an axonal damage. Number two, nerve conduction study. Nerve conduction study features are different in demyelinating type and axonal type. In demyelinating type, there is conduction slowing and block, whereas in axonal type, there is decreased amplitude of the action potential without conduction slowing. So conduction slowing in demyelinating type and decreased action potential amplitude in axonal type. Number three, MRI of the spinal cord. It shows thickening of the cauda equina and intrathecal nerve root. So thickening of the cauda equina and intrathecal nerve root. And number four, oligoclonal bands present on high resolution electrophoresis. Now diagnostic criteria. Number one, weakness of two or more limbs due to neuropathy. Number two, rapidly evolving ascending paralysis with areflexia and symmetric weakness with absence of fever. Treatment should be started as soon as possible after the first sign symptom of the disease. Why? Because immunotherapy is not effective 2 weeks after the appearance of the sign symptoms. So the treatment is IV immunoglobulins or plasmapheresis. IV immunoglobulins is given 2 grams per kg per day or plasmapheresis 4 times per week. The advantage of this treatment is that it reduces the need for mechanical ventilation by nearly half. So 50% reduction in mechanical ventilation with immunoglobulin therapy or plasmapheresis, and this increases the likelihood of full recovery in 1 year. What about glucocorticoid? Glucocorticoids are not effective. Vital capacity of less than 30% indicates diaphragmatic involvement and requires intubation and mechanical ventilation. 30% of the patient require ventilatory support. Now, answers to the questions. What are different types of Guillain-Barré syndrome? We have done it briefly here. 2 types of Guillain-Barré syndrome: demyelinating type with full recovery and axonal type with poor recovery. What are the features of autonomic system involvement? Wide variation in BP, postural hypertension and cardiac arrhythmias. Question number 3, what's albuminocytologic dissociation? Already done, increased protein and normal cell count. Question number 4, what's Miller-Fisher syndrome? Miller-Fisher syndrome, without weakness, there is rapidly evolving ataxia and areflexia of the limbs and ophthalmoplegia, often with pupillary paralysis. So there is ataxia, areflexia, ophthalmoplegia with pupillary paralysis. Question number 5, which infectious agents are implicated in causing GBS? Campylobacter jejuni, most common, EB virus, influenza, and mycoplasma pneumonia. Why full recovery occurs in demyelinating Guillain-Barré syndrome? Full recovery in demyelinating type of Guillain-Barré syndrome is due to remyelination because the axonal connections remain intact. And to get a full recovery, axons should be intact. So recovery can take place as remyelination occurs.